Hey guys, Nick Foy here from under30wealth.com, and this quick video is going to be discussing whether real estate investment entities like an LLC can secure a bank loan for a property. So this is a common question you're going to have when you set up your LLC, is are you going to be able to get a loan in the LLC's name? So first of all, a few things to point out. You're going to want to talk with a mortgage broker or, you know, a loan officer with a bank. They're going to be able to give you a more concrete answer with, you know, that's more accurate. But based off my research, my experience, my knowledge doing this, they're going to treat your LLC just like they would you as a person. They're going to look at its income history. So has your LLC been operating for the past few years as a business? What kind of income has it been producing as a business? And it's going to base off, you know, how much loan you can qualify for off the business income. And then they're also going to look at, you know, if your LLC has established a credit history, you know, taking out loans or having a business credit card or things like that to show that you've, you know, your business is making payments on those liabilities and credits so that the bank doesn't worry about you missing a mortgage payment. So it's kind of similar to being a human being. You know, they're going to treat your entity similar. And from there, if for some reason your LLC doesn't qualify, it doesn't have enough income history or a good enough credit history yet, then what they're going to do is they're going to want to look at you and they're going to look at your personal income and your personal credit score. And they're probably going to make you get a loan under your name instead of the LLC's name. And then once your LLC gets established for a while, then you're going to be able to start getting a loan under the LLC. So a few tips, basically one, try to establish credit lines that will grow with the company. So an example would be to get a credit line that's based on a percentage of your receivables rather than a constant static amount. This way, as your business grows, so does your credit line. So once those your account receivables starts increasing, you know, your credit line will. So a bank will review your credit line annually, most likely. But again, you're going to want to talk to a mortgage or a loan officer to figure out how they look at LLCs and kind of judge their credit lines. Once you start your LLC, use the LLC officer's credit to gain approval under the business name. So initially, starting out, I've had to, you know, be looked at as, you know, the owner of the LLC. They would look at me and my business partner first. So they're going to look at our credit scores to approve if they can give our entity a loan or not, or to give us a loan under our personal names. But if you're using your LLC, you're going to want to have an EIN number. So this should come, you know, when you file your LLC's taxes every year, you're going to have an EIN number. So you're going to need to give that to the bank. You also want to put a paid for property into an LLC to give it some assets. So what we had to do with our first property we bought it all cash in our personal names, and then we just quit claim deeded over to the LLC so that it got it out of ownership of our personal name, and now it became owned by the LLC. So in the property records, when somebody looks up tax information or owner information on that property, it'll say the LLC's name and our names will be hidden. People won't be able to know that we own it. It'll just say our entity name. So by doing that, you know, banks are going to see that your LLC owns some assets. It has some value. It's not just a blank shell company with no assets. So it's going to give it some real value. That way they know they could turn to that real estate if they ever had to foreclose on the loan. They could come after, you know, some assets that the LLC owns, which typically real estate is what backs a loan. So that's a good starting point for getting your LLC some assets. And then step four, sometimes an investment property like commercial lending situations will suffice. And if it has good enough cash flow, they look at all the signed leases by the tenants. So they're going to be able to compare the income the property's producing against its debts. So this is called the debt coverage ratio. How well can you cover your debt payments using the operating income of the investment property? So if you buy like an apartment building that's producing thousands of dollars per year in net income, they're going to look at how much income you're making off that apartment building compared to how much mortgage you're trying to take out on the property, and they'll compare the income to debt ratio. All right, next we're going to get into the difference between a non-recourse and a recourse loan. So the simple way of explaining this difference is it comes down to which assets a lender can go after if your borrower fails to repay the loan. So lenders, they're going to obviously favor a recourse loan, while a buyer is going to favor a non-recourse loan. So in both types of these loans, lenders can seize assets used as collateral to secure the loan. So typically, the real estate you're buying is what's going to be used as collateral against the loan. So if you were to stop making mortgage payments and the lender decided to foreclose on you, they would take over your investment property and they could sell it to recoup their loan money. So that's kind of what happens with any type of loan, non-recourse or recourse. So the big difference here is what happens after, you know, they seize property and sell it. So in a non-recourse loan, they can only come after the property and whatever value they get for the property that satisfies, you know, the loan, and then you're off the hook. You know, even if the loan balance was more than what the property was worth, so if we have a big downturn and, you know, a $200,000 property now is only worth $100,000 and the mortgage is worth $150,000, they're going to be, you know, underwater. So they're going to take over the property and that's it. That's a non-recourse loan. A recourse loan is the one the lender favors. So basically, this is the one where they can still come after you for the remaining loan balance. So if you've got, you know, cash in your bank account or a car, I mean, there's other assets they could potentially come after you for to try to finish satisfying the debt that you owe on your original loan. So that's kind of the big difference there between recourse and non-recourse, is it's whether or not that the bank can come after additional assets to try to pay off the rest of that loan if for some reason the real estate value isn't high enough to cover the loan balance. So that's a little bit of an intro into loans with LLCs, legal entities. I've got a free guide here on how to set up an LLC. You can subscribe to my email community and I'll send it over to you via email. So if you check out this blog post, I'll link to it below in this video. And then you can read through the article. I've also got a real estate investing course that's going to cover everything you need to know to buy your first investment property. So you can check that out. And I've also got a bunch of additional articles and resources for you to check out as well. So make sure to check out that article below in this video. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you guys tomorrow in the next video lesson.